Welcome students, my name is Dr. Praneeth and today we will see about the first unit in this pharmaceutical organic chemistry 2 that is the topic name is first unit name is benzene and its derivatives. So today we will see there is some introduction about the benzene, the structure, the properties, how the benzene react with some other chemical to make new compounds like that. So let's see this interesting topic for today, benzene and its derivative. Let's start. So this outline I have given for this presentation, this class is, first I will give some introduction about benzene, and then I will move on to see, to show you how the benzene's physical and chemical properties. Okay. Then we will see about how to prepare the benzene, that is synthesis of benzene. After that I will discuss about some electrophilic reaction, how the benzene react with some electrophiles, and the substitution effects we will see in the other classes, the next coming next classes. So today we will see about this introduction, physical chemical properties, synthesis, and the some introduction about the electrophilic reaction. There are many reactions, so today we'll see just the outline, and finally we'll see about the uses of benzene and its derivative. This is the introduction, that outline for this unit 1. So let's see the introduction about benzene. So what is benzene? Benzene is a very basic organic compound, right? Because it contains only carbon and hydrogen, and it forms like a ring structure, like hexagon ring structure, as you can see here. So benzene, the molecular formula is C6H6. So it contains 6 carbon and 6 hydrogen, and this is the structure of benzene. It's having 3 double bonds inside, and the benzene is classified under hydrocarbons because it contains only hydrogen and carbon, so it is classified under hydrocarbons, and it is an aromatic compound. So whichever it benzene is an aromatic compound because it is it satisfies some important points which we will discuss in the later classes. So now let's see how the benzene is occurred. Benzene is formed in trace amounts in petroleum and coal. Okay, it is a byproduct which is obtained when we dig the petrol, when we cut the petrol and coal. This is a benzene, also a byproduct. This is the occurrence in naturally. And the physical properties is, it is a colorless liquid at room temperature. At room temperature, it is colorless liquid, means when we cool down, little bit cool down, it becomes solidified. So it becomes a solid, so white solid. So this is the physical properties of the benzene. It is immiscible with water, meaning it is not soluble, it is not miscible with water. Okay, it is not go, it will, if you add water to the benzene, it will get 2 layers, like when we get when we put some oil into the water, we'll get 2 layers, right? Because oil is not miscible with water. Similarly, benzene is also not miscible with water. So it is highly flammable, so it's called inflammable, right? So it will be very dangerous, and it is having an aromatic smell, so it's having some nice good smell. Now let's see some details about the structural features. Benzene, the structure is shown without hydrogen. This structure is shown without hydrogen. You can see that it contains 6 carbon, right? 6 carbon, and it also contains 6 hydrogen. This is shown in this structure. This is structure of the benzene with hydrogens. So each corner contains one hydrogen. So there are total 6 hydrogen. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hydrogen and 6 carbon. All the 6 carbon are equivalent, meaning all the 6 carbons are same, because it is having a symmetry, right? It is having a symmetry here also. There are many symmetries are involved in this structure. So all the carbon and hydrogens are same, right? If you turn the structure, you will get the same structure, right? If you turn this structure, you will get same. Every time you rotate the structure, you get the same compound because all are same. and the carbon and this hydrogen angle is 120 degree. So this angle of this benzene, right, this carbon, carbon, hydrogen, this angle is 120. So benzene, I told, benzene contains three double bonds, right? So you can see here 1, 2, 3 inside, that is the double bonds are made of pi electrons. So it's made of 6 pi electrons, because each double bond, this one double bond contain 2 pi electrons. So there are 3 double bonds, so it is contains 6 pi electrons. These pi electrons makes the benzene electron rich, right? Because there is inside there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons are there, 6 pi electrons which makes bond, which makes this pi bond. So it will rotate, these electrons will rotate into the circulate in the benzene ring, and this makes it more electron rich, meaning this having more electrons inside, right? And this is very important in the, if you can see the reactions of benzene, this property, this having this pi electrons is very important, because for reaction with other positive charge species, right, electrophile is a positive charge species, this electron is very important, because this electron attacks this positive species. So this electron rich property of the benzene is very important for its reaction. Now let's move on to see the synthesis of benzene, how the benzene is prepared. There are four different methods, four or five methods I have given here. You can see one by one. These are all different methods. You can use any method to get the benzene. Right? This is the first method, synthesis of benzene from acetylene. Acetylene is this compound, CH, triple bond CH. Right? There are three triple bonds are present. You can see 1, 2, 3. When acetylene, when you pass the acetylene into a red hot tube, if you take a tube and pass the acetylene, and this tube is heated at very high temperature, 873 Kelvin. You can see it's a very high temperature, right? Because 273 Kelvin is 2798 Kelvin is 23 degrees Celsius. So we can see this how much more. It's around 600 degree Celsius. If we can we pass through the acetylene to the red hot tube, we'll get benzene, right? And thus, by benzene is prepared by passing the acetylene gas through the red hot tube. This is the first method. And the second method, you can prepare benzene by taking this carboxylic acid. Okay, this is carboxylic acid is phenyl ring, benzene ring, COOH hydrogen. If you remove hydrogen and put the sodium, you will get the sodium benzoate, right? So sodium benzoate plus sodium hydroxide, in the presence of calcium oxide, you will get the benzene. This is the second method. And you also get the sodium carbonate, you also get this. So this reaction is decarboxylation reaction, because the carbon dioxide is coming out, right? Carbon dioxide is coming out and it reacts with this one to form the sodium carbonate. So it is a decarboxylation reaction, and you can see that in the left hand side. So this arrow, this is the left hand side of the arrow. This is called reactant, right? These are called reactant, and this is product, right hand side of the arrow. All the carbon, hydrogen, sodium, oxygen, everything is balanced. Okay, there are two sodiums are there in the right hand side. There are also two sodiums in the left hand side. You can see sodium here and sodium here. This is called this reactions is balanced. Third method, we can prepare the benzene from phenol. This is a reduction reaction, because it is involved the zinc. Zinc atom is involved. Okay, zinc is used for reduction purpose. Reduction means addition of hydrogen, right? Oxidation means addition of oxygen. Reduction means addition of hydrogen. So you can see here, the benzene is formed. Oxygen is gone here, right? And hydrogen added to the benzene. Because this is having hydrogen, right? Each carbonyl is having one hydrogen. So removal of oxygen is called as reduction. Okay, addition of oxygen also is called as reduction. Oxidation. So in this one, reduction is happening because removal of oxygen. Oxygen went to zinc, okay, and addition of hydrogen. This hydrogen went added to the benzene ring here. So benzene can be prepared by reduction of phenols using zinc. This is the fourth method, we can prepare the benzene from sulfonic acid. This is benzene and this is the SO3H. SO3H is a sulfonic acid. Okay, if you take this benzene and eat it in the presence of sodium hydrogen sulfate, sorry, sulfuric acid, this sulfuric acid, at this 100 degree Celsius, you will get benzene plus H2SO4, you will also get back. Okay. So this is by eating benzene sulfonic acid, benzene can be formed. So these are the four different methods you can use to prepare benzene. Next, we'll see the aromatic properties of benzene. Why the benzene is called, is classified under aromatic compounds? I've said that benzene is classified under hydrocarbons, right? Because it contains carbon and hydrogen. It is also classified under aromatic compounds because this has to satisfy some points. What are the points we'll see? The compound should be cyclic. So the first important point, okay, to satisfy, to get, to make the benzene aromatic. Compound must be cyclic, meaning cycle means is not only the round shape, it can be different shape also, right? The main, the important point is, if you start from one point, if you go, you should reach the same point without any break. Okay, if you see the benzene here, benzene is cyclic because if you start, for example, if you start from this point, you can go, okay, you can go and you can reach back this point again without any break. There is no break here because everything is having a bond. So this is cyclic system. Benzene is a cyclic system. So it is satisfy this first point, that this compound should be cyclic in order to be an aromatic compound. Compound must be planar. This is the second important point. Means compound should be flat, right? It should not be like this, tickled or wiggled. It should be flat. Benzene, if you see, benzene is a very flat molecule, right? If you see a 3D structure of benzene, you can see this benzene is very flat. Okay? It's a very flat molecule. So this also satisfies. So it is a planar, flat molecule. Compound should contain delocalized double bond. This is the third important point for a compound to be aromatic compound. What is the meaning of delocalized double bonds? It is nothing but alternate double bond, right? Alternate. It is not localized. The double bond can go also, move also. So you can see here, benzene is having a single bond, double bond, single bond, right? Double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. It is having an alternate single and double bond, right? And this double bond can go here, and this double bond can go here, this double bond can go here. This can circulate, it can circulate. So it is delocalized, meaning it is not staying in one position, it can also move. And it important point is, it is contain alternate single and double bond, should contain. So make it delocalized. So this also the benzene is satisfied. Fourth important point is that it should follow, any compound should follow this Uccle's rule, okay, in order to be aromatic compounds. These four important rules should be satisfied so that the compound is called as an aromatic compound. So we will see whether the benzene satisfies this rule, this Uccle's rule, okay, which we'll see in the later class. So these are the some reactions of benzene. We'll see in the reactions of benzene, we will see only this electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, this is a I already told that benzene is an electron rich compound, right? Because it contains a pi bond. Pi bond is made of electrons, so it is an electron rich compound. So electron rich species likes to react or attack the positive species, because this is a negative species, can attack the positive species. These are the electrophiles. Electrophiles are the positive ions or positive chemicals species, chemical species. So electrophiles are positive chemical species or positive ions. So benzene react with these electrophiles. Okay, so this benzene, and see here, this E plus is an electrophile, and it forms a new compound like substituted benzene. The substituted benzene will form. This is a new compound, meaning there is a hydrogen here, right? There is hydrogen here. This hydrogen will be removed, and this E plus will be attached here. can see here this E plus is attached with a single bond. There's also this 5 hydrogens are here. This is a new substituted compound of benzene. So under this electrophilic reaction, we'll see the subheading is chlorination reactions of benzene. Okay, so benzene react with chlorine, Cl2 chlorine, in the presence of iron chloride, you'll get chlorobenzene. Okay, chlor plus hydrogen chloride. So this is a electrophilic reaction because benzene react with an electrophile, right? Here, if in the first case we don't see any positive charge because this is the general reaction, right? This is the basic reaction. It reacts with chlorine. In the presence of iron chloride, it will give, you'll get chlorobenzene plus HCl. In the mechanism, we see this reaction. In the mechanism, we can see how the electrophile is generating. So this is the Lewis acid catalyst, iron chloride. So Lewis acid catalyst is, the definition for the Lewis acid catalyst, Lewis acid is the one which will accept an electron pair. So this Lewis acid will take two electrons from, for example, you can see in the mechanism, this iron chloride is a Lewis acid, will take two electrons from the chlorine. So this is the Lewis acid catalyst, which is important for the reaction to proceed. Okay, this we will see in the mechanism in the next slide. So now we move on to see the mechanism of this chlorination reaction, which is an electrophilic substitution reaction, because benzene react with this chlorine to form the chlorobenzene. So new product is forming, right? This is the electrophilic substitution reaction. Under this, we'll see the mechanism how the chlorination reaction is occurring. So this is the reaction mechanism. This is the first step. There are three steps involved in this chlorination reaction. And this is the first step. So in the first step, what will happen is this Lewis acid catalyst, iron chloride, right? We already told that Lewis acid catalyst is a catalyst which accepts an electron pair, right? So this Lewis acid iron chloride accepts electron from the chlorine molecule, Cl. So this I have draw in this way, Cl bond Cl. Okay, or you can also write Cl2, both are same. So this chlorine, this iron chloride accept an electron pair, electrons from the chlorine molecule, and it forms this molecular complex with a positive charge on chlorine. There is a new bond is forming between this chlorine molecule and this iron chloride. Okay, there is a new bond here formed here. And after that, this is not stable. This molecular complex is very unstable, so it decomposes. It decomposes here, it breaks here and forms this Cl plus and iron chloride, FeCl4-. You can see that we got the electrophile, right? We got this, Cl plus is an electrophile, E plus is the Cl. In the place of E, you have to put Cl, this is the C plus. So we got our electrophile in the first step. So what will happen in the second step? You can easily imagine that once the electrophile is produced, that is the Cl plus is produced, the Cl is a positive charge, having is a positive charge, right? And benzene is having electrons, that pi electrons. These pi electrons will attack the positive charge, right? Negative attacks the positive. So these electrons, these pi electrons attacks the positive charge in the second step. So this is what I have shown here. Electron rich benzene attacks this chloronium ion. This CL plus is called as chloronium ion, which is an electrophile. And it forms this resonant stabilized cation intermediate, because there is a new bond will form here. This bond will go and form here, Cl. So this bond is gone and it is having a positive charge in the benzene ring. There is having a positive charge, and this intermediate is between the product and the reactant. That is called intermediate. This is not the product. Okay, this is an intermediate between product and reactant. So this intermediate is stabilized because this double bond can move around now. Because it's a positive charge, this double bond can move around. Always imagine that whenever there is a positive charge are there, electrons will try to go there. Okay, because this need electron. This is a positive charge, this need electrons, right? So this bond will go. So this bond moves here and the positive charge comes to this bond here, because now the carbon is having three bonds only. 1, 2 and this hydrogen. And then what happens? This bond can move. This pi electron can move here, this pi bond, this moved here, and the positive charge will move here. Like this, this intermediate is stabilized because this double bond is moving, positive charge is moving. So it is stabilized for some time so that the next step can happen. Now, this is a very important thing to understand, this concept. Positive charge is delocalized onto the three carbon atoms because the positive charge here, positive charge is here, positive charge is here. Positive charge is moving in all the three carbon atoms. So it is getting stabilized. So the next step can happen. Now this is the next step, final step. In the next step, the resonant stabilized cation intermediate transfer a proton to FeCl4-. Okay, this FeCl4- is generated in the first step. You got the iron chloride in the first step, right? In the first step, you'll get the Cl plus FeCl4-. So this is this coming in the third step, and this proton, this H plus, is transferred to the iron chloride, and this bond is there, right? This bond will move inside, okay, because there is a positive charge here. This bond will move inside and it will form this chlorobenzene. This hydrogen is gone, okay, hydrogen is gone here. So this hydrogen will form HCl, H and 1Cl, HCl, plus you get back the iron chloride, iron trichloride, that is the Lewis acid catalyst. You will get regenerated the catalyst. So catalyst once formed, once used, it came back again, it will do the reaction again. Product will form, catalyst will regenerate it, do the reaction again. Like that, this catalyst is regenerated, it will go back and produce more product again and again. Once all the benzene is finished, this will be free. So this is the final step in the chlorination reaction. So far what we have seen is, we have seen the introduction about the benzene. We have seen the structure, how the benzene structure is formed, right? It is a hexagonal structure. It is having carbon, hydrogen, right? 6 carbon and 6 hydrogen. And we have also seen the properties and also why the benzene is called as an aromatic compound, because it satisfies some rules, right? And it satisfies all these rules. We have to see the Ockels rule, which will be in the later class. And then we will see, we have seen this, some reactions of benzene. Importantly, the benzene is an electron-rich species. It reacts with an electrophile, that is a positive species, to form new compounds. And for that, the example we have seen is the chlorine. Chlorination of benzene. Benzene reacts with chlorine to form the chlorobenzene. We have also seen the mechanism of this reaction, how the reaction is occurring actually. It is having three steps. The first step will get the Cl plus, that is an electrophile. The second step, benzene attacks the Cl plus to form the product. And in the final step, this is which is shown here, the proton is removed, right? The H is removed and this bond will migrate from the chlorobenzene. So far we have seen all this, and this is the this is all for today's class, and I will see you in the next class. And in the second class, we will discuss more about the reactions of benzene. Thank you very much.